स्याबद्बत्तजनाते हन्दगुभृत्युमन्येषु अविचार्यधुन्नं स्तम्भे वधारस्तमनन्यलभ्यं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहं शरणं प्रपद्ये अहोबिले गरुडशैलमध्ये कृपावशात्कल्पितसन्निधानं लक्ष्म्या समालिङ्गितवामभागं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहं शरणं प्रपद्ये श्रीमते श्रीलक्ष्मीनृसिंहपरब्रह्मणे नमः अस्मद्गुरुभ्यो नमः अस्मत्सर्वगुरुभ्यो नमः अस्मत्परमगुरुभ्यो नमः प्रपद्ये निरवत्यानां निषद्यां गुणसम्बधां शरणं भवभीतानां षडगोपमुनीश्वरं श्रीरङ्गनाथषडगोपयदीन्द्रदृष्टं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहषडजित्करुणैकपात्रं श्रीरङ्गवीररघुराट्षडगोपहृदयं वेदान्तदेशीयदीन्द्रमहं प्रपद्ये श्रीमदे शिवं षडगोप श्रीवेदान्तदेशिकेरीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः श्रीमत्रङ्गषडारिसंव्यविवरात् लब्धागमान्धद्वयं श्रीमद्वीररघुत्महात्यषडचित् पाधारविन्दाश्रयं श्रीमद्वेदवदं सदेशिकयधेः कारुण्यवीक्षास्पदं सेवे रङ्गदुरीनशासनवशम् नारायणं योगिनं श्रीमदे श्रीलक्ष्मीनृसिंहदिव्यपादुकासेवक श्रीमन्षडगोपश्रीनारायणयदीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः वेदान्तदेशिकेन्द्रकटाक्षलब्ध त्रयन्तसारमणवत्यगुणम्बुदाग्र्यं नारायणात्यधिधुर्यकृपाभिषिक्तं श्रीरङ्गनाथयदिशेखरमाश्रयामहाम् श्रीमदे शिवं षडगोप श्रीरङ्गनाथेन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः यो नित्यमच्युतपथाम्बुजयुग्मरुग्म व्यामोघदस्तदितराणि तृणाय मेने अस्मद्गुरोर्भगवतोऽस्यदेकसिन्धोः रामानुजस्य चरणौ शरणं प्रपद्ये तस्मै रामानुजार्याय नमः परमयोगिने यश्रुतिस्मृतिसूत्राणाम् अन्तर्ज्वरम् अशीषमद् प्रणामं लक्ष्मणमुनिः पदिगृह्णातु मामहं प्रसादयत्सूक्तिः स्वाधीनपदिघां श्रुतिं श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्य कविधार्किककेसरी वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि ज्ञानानन्दमयं देवं निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतिम् आधारं सर्वविद्यानां हयग्रीवमुपास्महे गुरुभ्यः तद्गुरुभ्यश्च नमो वाहम् अधीमहे वृणीमहे च तत्राद्यौ दम्पती जगदाम्पती उल्लासपल्लविदपालिकसप्तलोकी निर्वाहघोरगिदनेमकटाक्षलीलाम् श्रीरङ्गहर्म्यदलमङ्गलदीपरेगां श्रीरङ्गराजमहिषीं श्रयमाश्रयामहप्रायप्रवदने पुंसां पौनःपुण्यं निवारयन् अष्टश्रीरङ्गभर्तुर्मां अव्यात् अभयमुद्रितः अखिलभुवनजन्मस्तेमभङ्गादिलीले विनदविविधभूतौ राधरक्षैकदीक्षे श्रुतिशिरसि विदीप्ते ब्रह्मणि श्रीनिवासे भवतु मम परस्मिन् सेमुषी भक्तिरूपा पराशर्यवचःसुदाम्बुपनिषत् दुःखाब्धिमद्योदृतां संसाराग्निविदीपनव्यपगद प्राणात्मसञ्जीवनीं पूर्वाचार्यसुरक्षिदां बहुमति व्यागाददूरस्थितां आनीतां तु निजाक्षरैः सुमनसो భౌమాభివందన్వహం వ్యరంజాయింగ్ శ్రీభాష్యం భగవత్ రామానుజర్స్ క్రౌన్ జల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ ఆఫ్ బాదరాయణర్స్ బ్రహ్మసూత్ర ఫ్రమ్ ది శారీరక శాస్త్ర విశిష్టాద్వైత శ్రీ వైష్ణవ సిద్ధాంతం ఇట్ ఈస్ క్లాసిఫైడ్ ఇన్ టు 4 లెవెల్స్ అధ్యాయం పాదం అధికరణం సూత్రాస్ 4 adhyayams are there. In each adhyayam, 4 padams are there. Totally 156 adhigaranam, 545 sutras are there. Where are we now? We are in the fourth adhyayam, paladhyayam, sadhyam, ubeyam, palan, rewards. We are in the second padam called utkranti padam. Simply the process of dying, the process of death. Here 11 adhikaranams are there. In 4-2, 11 adhikaranams. Out of which the first four adhikaranas we have discussed. What we got finally? All the indriyams goes and joins, we get a nice package. The package is the sukshma sariram. Sukshma panjabhuda sariram. That is what we got. Within the sthulam, something is drained out and put it into that. That is what Bhagavan's, what do you call, Bhagavan's karyam. So he does those actions and all of them. So he puts all those things into this. So you have a small miniature of you. The macro is the sthulam, the miniature, the micro level, that is the sukshmam. Macro and micro, sthulam and sukshmam. Within you, it is created before the process of death, that package. So, inside that sukshmam, we got everything. We got the vak, manas, all those things going there, and the jivan and the pranan, and all of them are staying inside over there. That package is the one will be inserted to the Brahmanadi for Bhakti Yogi, finally ready for moksham, or for a Prabhanan, ready for the moksham, it would be done. So this is what we have done up to the fourth one. The fifth adhikarana, what we are seeing here, Ashrudi Vakrama Adhikaranam. Here, when we talk about 11 sutras are there, what is the purpose of this adhikaranam first? The purpose, want to say that one, Utkranti, the process of death, the Atma getting out of the macro shariram, sthula shariram, is common for everyone. That means, very simple, everyone dies. Whether that person is a Brahma Upasagan, Bhakti Yogi, or non-upasagan, ordinary samsari. So he does not care all of them. He enjoys the world and he dies and he is reborn. So for all of them, utkranti happens. So there are two things are sure, as they say, death and taxes. So exactly, the death is the one what we are doing. Taxes is the one what is your punya pavam. Okay, that is definite for everyone. So the dying happens for anyone, whether he is doing a Bhakti Yogam or not a Bhakti Yogam at all. Upasagan Bhakti Yogi, the package is pushed through the Brahma Nadi. For others, it goes through the 100 different Nadis anywhere. We enjoyed only one sutra last class. Very difficult one. Emperumanar amazingly proves, compared to all other Upanishads putting it together, this is the right way to interpret. See, many, many times we are told in the Sri Bhashyam, the way we have to go, tatvam, what is the purushartham, what is the hidam. Understand who you are. Understand who is the Bhagavan. That is what is basically needed. Then where you want to go. If you don't know where you are, you cannot go to any destination because it doesn't make any sense. As opposed to, I want to go to that Purusharthaṁ. You already decided, this is what I want to do, without your qualification. Aham Brahmasmi, I am the Brahmam. You take that one and you cannot change all those things in front of them, convenient to you, and saying this is the Mahavakyam, all others are not important. That's not the way to do. So, Emperumanar says, this is the other way, first to find out who you are. This person did not pass the 7th grade. How he is going to become an IAS officer? My Acharya used to say this example. So understand who you are. So we have to find what is good for us. So when we go through the tattvam, this is how we have to go. So when the dharmijnanam inside it says, I am a slave to the Bhagavan, Aham Brahmasmi, I am the Brahmam, I am the God, does not work. It will not happen to you. So we have to understand where we are, where we want to go, what is the path. Tattvam, Purushartham, and Hidam. So that is what he is saying. So what we saw yesterday, we look at it differently today. Look at that one saying that this 495, the first sutra out of seven sutras here, samanacha ashrudi ubakramat amrutatvam cha anubhoshya. What it basically says, a person when he stays over here, he is going to enjoy all the Brahma Palan. So that is what. So when you look at that one, Asridi Ubakramat, before entering into the Brahmanadi, up to that, Samanacha, everything is same for all of them. And then Amrutatvam cha anubhoshya, that person, when he goes into that Brahmanadi and all of them, he enjoys that one here itself, Amrutatvam. Great happiness is declared to him. And the Sarira Indriyams are still there. It's not eliminated. So, that is what? The mode for the Atma depends from the Sariram is common. Because we go to the common one, see, if you are going from New York to London, go to that place and a terminal there and you bifurcate, go into different places and everything. Similarly, the packaging happens for all the people. Only the Brahma Upasakan goes through Murdanyanadi. That is what we say. It's common for all until the commencement of the path, Murdanyanadi Pravesham. The immortality, Amrutatvam, is obtained for him. It does not say Utkranti. He gets immediately, actually without burning the connected Stula Sariram. So that is how they are explaining. What is, you have to remember this one. How do we correctly interpret this one? The Upasagan enjoys Amrutam. They call that is Moksham. Brahma Prapti. Here itself. With the Stula Sariram, that is the Advaitam. They are referring that. So now, let's look at how Embruman are going to do from a different angle coming from there. So take the Kadobanishad Vakyam, it says, Sadam chaika cha hridayasya natyaham dhasa murdhanam abhinishrudaikam dayodhvamayan amrutatvamedi vishvam anya utkramane bhavanti. Sadam cha yega natya hridayasya, from the heart there are 101, 100 plus 1 nadis are going. Dasam yega murdhanam abhinishrudaha, amongst that one of them is calling Murdanya nadi, Susumna nadi towards the head. Abhinishrudaha, breaking and going. Daya ayan urdvam amrutatvam edi, anybody goes through that one, he attains the deathless state. Amrutatvam, when he means immortality, he gets that. Anya utkramane vishvang bhavanti, others are going other ways. Embermana tells this Upanishad Vakyam clearly indicates Upasagan has to go through the Brahmanadi to attain Brahmanubhavam. He cannot say that only he has to be here. That Brahmanadi going out there, Utkranti has to happen. That is what this says. And all others are going to say later on in the other Upanishads and everything, he crosses the Viraja river, he has been received by all of them. All those things are there. So, when you look at this one, Sadam Chaiga Hridayasya, when you look at the Kadobanishad Bhakyam, it has to go through the Brahmanadi, it says. So, Embermana does not say, this is what I am saying, all others are not important. No, 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 this is important what I am saying. This is the correct meaning. But what you are telling, you have to interpret differently. That's not correct, I will do. So, unlike Advaitam or others, they take only certain parts of the Veda important, others they discard. See, we are a family. In the family, let's say there are 10 kids are there. In the 10 kids are there, one kid is saying something what we should do. So the father says, what he says is right. You guys are all not important. Father cannot say that. He needs all the kids. He cannot disown them. Father should say, What he says is correct. What you guys are telling may not be correct. Let me give you why it is not correct and how do we compromise all of them. So he has to go and talk to all the kids and make some kind of a relevance, some kind of a reconciliation. That is what Emperumana does. That is one of the greatest thing with the Sribhashyam is, unlike all others, Visishtadvaita Siddhantam respect every single syllable of Vedas. You don't ignore any of them. All the kids are important for the parent. One kid may be making $1 million, the other one be $100. One got a Nobel Prize, the other one. But all of them, after all, you are all my kids. I need all of them. One may be in a spotlight. That does not mean all others are not. See, in Amarvar Pasuram, we are taking Tiruvaimuri. Agalagille Nirayam Endru, we say that one. So, because it's a Shanagari Pasuram, it is a Dvayam. But that does not mean all others are bad. Because it hits your head so easily, you are. But every single Pasuram of Namarvar is great. Similarly, every single line of Veda, every single Shabdam, each one of them is important there. So now, going back here, Yada sarve pramuchyante kama yesya hridi shrudha adamartyo mrudho bhavadi attara brahma samashnude. Advaitam, you are taking this Kadopanishad Vakyam and where it says there, kama hridi shrudha, all the kamams are going. This is very important. Okay? Whether you talk Uddhava Gita, whether you talk Bhagavad Gita, whether you talk Tiruvaimuri, whether you talk Brahma Sutram, Sribhashyam, everything is your desire. Semushi Bhakti Rupa. Okay? Make my jnanam not goes into the worldly things, but towards Bhakti, towards Bhagavan. Tumta sarvam parityacha snegam sojana bandushu mayi avesya mana samyak. So, unless you turn into bhakti towards Bhagavan, you cannot say, aham brahmasmi. That is what we are trying to say. So, yada sarve pramuchyante kama hridi shrida, all the kamas are going to the heart. Sarve pramuchyante, all of them he removed. So, he does not have any desire. Actually, that doesn't work. Mukur Arayasinghar used to say, yes, you need asai. So, when you go into sadhana sadushtyam, fourth one, mumukshutvam, desire of moksham, craving of moksham, you should have asai. That's why Desikan says, if it is a kamam is going there, block it. I don't want it anymore. Put a wall. He does not say that. What Desikan says, make a U-turn. Don't go into the worldly things. Turn that asai into whatever you are having the desire towards the car or the house or to the spouse or to the kids. If you put it on the Bhagavan, how much you going to get it? That is what he says. So, sarve pramuchyante, the Veda Vakyam says here, when you remove all this kamam, adamartyo amurdo bhavati, that person enjoys the deathless state. Atra, there itself, Brahma Samashnude. He get the Brahma Prapti. So, if you remove the kamam, you got everything. So, when they go, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyagara, dhyana, dharana, so samadhi, they go through 8 levels of them. Bhakti yogi, when you go that one, I removed all of them, I got it, I got the jiva mukti. That's what they are saying. Here, adamartyo amurdo bhavadi, when it says, he receives the moksham, that what you call deathless state, here itself. How can it happen when you have a sthula sariram? How can you get that? So they say, there is no utkranti for him. Death doesn't make any difference. He has got jiva mukti, he is already in moksham. Moksham is a state, not a place. Moksham is in the jnanam. That is Advaita is saying. What we are saying, you divide by the Viraja river, above is the moksham, below is the Leela Vibhuti and everything. We are saying it's a place. We have to travel there. Archiradi Margam, we have to go through that. So, adamartyo amurdam bhavadi, when he says that one, what it is, you are sitting in the boarding lounge. with the boarding pass. You think about it, go back and take a look. Am I worried about my house? Am I worried about any bill, any lawn mowing, any snow plowing? None of them. Nothing is going to connect me because I'm going to take the plane and go. So that makes you very happy. Think the day you did the Prabhati, you felt so happy on that way. Everything is removed. Bharanyasam. Bharanyasam. So bharam, na bharam. So what you are taking the load and give it to the Bhagavan. Bhagavan is always doing. That realization comes to us right now. So, aslesha vinasaha. Aslesha vinasaha means aslesha will not stick. Abuddhi purvagaram. Vinasa, all the other things will be. Sanjidam, prarabdam, agami. Everything is going to go away. Karma is going to be zeroed out. Karma is not going to be connected to you. So, thinking of that makes you very happy. And that is called Adamartyo Amurdho Bhavadi. The Upasagan, or whether it's a Brahmopasagan on the Brahma Vidya or the Nyasa Vidya, you feel very happy. I'm not going to have any more births. Nothing of these things is going to affect me. All my pavams are trillions of janmas going to go away. I feel very, very happy. So that happiness is talking about. Atra Brahma Samashnude. So he enjoys Brahmanubhavam here itself. How can he enjoy the Brahmanubhavam here itself? See, the example we gave, the person lives next to the White House. During the lunch time, he goes and plays the card game with the president. So both of them just sharing the lunch and playing the card. That is for 1 hour. After that, he has to go and you have to go. You cannot stay in the White House. So, this is a temporary Shughanubhavam. When they do the Bhakti Yogam, Brahmanubhavam is so amazing. Okay? So, as if the Bhagavan is standing in front of you, Pratyaksham. So, that is how you would be feeling that one. You would enjoy that one. We will not get that one. Prabhanan will not be getting this kind of a Sakshatkaram. But they will be getting all of them. They would be happy. But that is only as long, this is like, see, you are watching the Star Wars movie. You sit there and watch that one, your mind fully goes into that one. So you think you are traveling in all these worlds. But after the bell rings, the show is over, you walk back to your own house. All those things are gone. Similar to that one, Brahma Jnani, what they call as a Brahma, the Bhakti Yogi, he has doing the Dhyanam, Vedanam, Upasanam, about the 31 Brahma Vidyas, he enjoys the Bhagavan during that period only. Very similar to, we give in our example, right now you are having virtual reality. So, put the glass, virtual reality, you are sitting on the destination, you are in the boarding lounge, thinking of the destination, Hawaii. Hey, here's the virtual reality of Hawaii. So, you put that one, so as if you are walking in Hawaii, you are enjoying all of them you are seeing. Where is your leg? Your leg is still in the earth. Your leg is still in the boarding lounge. You may be, mind may be thinking. So that is what it says. Atra Brahma Samashnude means the Brahmanubhavam is Shuganurubam for you. That's all it is. Okay. So yes, it is great. It is virtual, not real. So here very rarely I take a Sribhashyam Moolam. But Adyan wants to read to you how Embarumanar very beautifully concluded. This is one of the most critical in the Sribhashyam to show what you mean by Jiva Mukti, what we mean by the Mukti when we reach the Moksham, eternal bliss. Those two are different completely. Only this is correct based on all the Upanishad Vakyam reconciling them. Anuboshya, when the Vakyam says, Anuboshya is enjoying that one. Sarirendriyadi sambandham adagdhaiva yat amurdatvam uttara purva yogor aslesha vinasha rubam prapyade tat uchyade yada sarve pramuchyande ityadigaya shridya idi artha. Idi artham. What is the artham for that one? உத்தர பூர்வாகயோ அஸ்லேஷ விநாசக. ஆல் தி பாஸ்ட் வில் பி பேர்ன்ட், ஆல் தி ஃபியூச்சர் அன்னோன் திங்ஸ் வில் நாட் ஸ்டிக் டு யூ. தட் மேக்ஸ் ஹிம் ஹாப்பி, தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அமிர்தத்வம். தென் அத்திர பிரம்ம சமஷ்ணுதே கடோபநேஷர் வாக்கியம் இஸ் இஸ் தேர் இட் செல்ஃப் இஸ் என்ஜாயிங் பிரம்மம். வாட் இஸ் எஸ் இதி ச உபாசன வேலாயாம் யோ பிரம்மானுபவ தத் விஷயம் இத் அபிப்பிராய. பிகாஸ் வேலாயாம் ஈ என்ஜாய்ஸ் தட் பகவான் ஓவர் ஹியர் இன் தி பக்தி ரூப தியானம் சாட்சாத்காரம் பகவான் கிவ்ஸ், ஈ என்ஜாய்ஸ் தட் ஒன். தட் இஸ் ஒய் ஈ என்ஜாய்ஸ் பிரம்மம் ஹியர். அஃப்கோர்ஸ் ஈ என்ஜாய்ஸ் தி பிரம்ம. அஃப்கோர்ஸ் யூ ஆர் சீயிங் ஆன் தி வர்ச்சுவல் ரியாலிட்டி. அஃப்கோர்ஸ் யூ ஆர் பிளேயிங் கார்ட் வித் தி பிரசிடென்ட். பட் ஹவு லாங்? பிகாஸ் வி ஆர் ஸ்டில் கண்ட்ரோல்டு பை பிரகிருதி அண்ட் காலம். ஓகே, பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி டைம் அண்ட் ஆஸ் வி சி இன் தி முக்குண மாயை இன் தி உத்தவ கீதா, சத்வ ராஜச தாமச குணம் ஒன்லி அப் டு சர்டன் எக்ஸ்டென்ட். ஸோ கண்டினியூங் ஃபர்தர், திஸ் இஸ் வாட் வி ஹட் அண்ட் ஐ டுக் அ லிட்டில் மோர் டைம் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் தட் ஒன். புட் எம்பெருமானார்ஸ் ரிஃப்யூட்டல் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அண்ட் தென் ஹவ் இ கம்ப்ரமைசிங் வித் ஆல் அதர்ஸ் அண்ட் எவ்ரி திங். வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட் ஒன் பார்ட் ஆஃப் திஸ் ஒன் ரெஸ்ட் ஆன் தி விசிட் ஆர் தி சித்தாந்தம். இட் சேஸ் மோக்ஷம் யூ ஹாட் டு கெட் அவுட் ஆஃப் திஸ் பாடி, கோ த்ரூ தி அர்ச்சிராதி மார்க்கம், கிராஸ் தி விரஜா ரிவர், தென் ஓன்லி யூ வில் கெட் இட். நாட் ஹியர், நாட் வித் திஸ் பாடி, நாட் விதவுட் கோயிங் அவுட். ஸோ ஆல் தோஸ் திங்ஸ் டஸ் நாட் கன்ஃபார்ம் டு தி உபனிஷத் ப்ராப்பர் இன்டர்பிரிட்டேஷன். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், ஸோ ஆல் திஸ் செவன் சூத்ராஸ் ஹியர் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டெல் பிரம்மோபாசகன் ஹாஸ் டு ஹவ் தி உத்கிராந்தி, இட் ஹாஸ் டு கம் அவுட். ததா பீதே சம்சார வியபதேஷாத். நெக்ஸ்ட் சூத்ரா 496. தத் தட் மோக்ஷம், தி மோக்ஷம் டிக்ளேர்ட் டு பி அப்டைன் ஆன் திஸ் ஸ்லோகம் இட் செல்ஃப். தட் இஸ் வாட் பூர்வ பக்ஷி இஸ் சேயிங், அப்போனன்ஸ் ஆர் சேயிங், யூ கோயிங் டு என்ஜாய் தி மோக்ஷம் ஹியர் இட் செல்ஃப். வாட் தே சே, தட் மோக்ஷம் தே காட் இட் ஆன் தி எர்த் இட் செல்ஃப் வித் தி ஸ்தூல சரீரம் இட் செல்ஃப். தட் ஒன் வென் யூ ஆர் லுக்கிங் ஆபீதே சம்சார வியபதேஷாத். Is being told, what is that? Abhide samsara. Samsaram is going to be there till you merge with the Brahmam. Up to the attainment of Brahmam, samsaram is start to be existing. You can say they are feeling the Brahmam, Brahmanubhavana. That is only temporary, not a permanent. Eternal bliss, that is what we are talking. Samsaram continues until attaining Paramapadam. Until we go to the Moksham, Samsaram is there. So, the Moksham what you are referring for a Brahmopasagan should be enjoying with his body only. What you are thinking is a temporary Anubhavam only. Now, lot of things we are very grossly simplifying in many places. In the Sribhashyam now, we are coming and try to confirm all these things more accurately, more refined. Karma and Samsaram. Most of the time, we say karma and samsaram are the same. It is not. Okay? Finely refining. Karma is gone. When the karma is gone, your sthula sariram falls down. Okay? Macro body falls down. Samsaram, your sukshma sariram still have to travel in the Prakriti Mandalam to go up to the Viraja river. So, samsaram continues. Okay, let me put this way. Karma free is when you leave the sthula sariram. Samsaram free when you leave the sukshma sariram. As simple as that. So, karma is gone when you do the sthula sariram fall down. Samsaram, still you are having your sukshma sariram, it has to travel in the Prakriti Mandalam. As long as you are in the Prakriti Mandalam, this is a samsaram, because that sukshma sariram what you got still made out of the Prakriti. It's not aprakridam. But We will worry about the Archiradi Margam in a little later to say Bhagavan will take care of that. You will not have any bad intentions. So, samsaram, when you say that karma free, sthula sariram is gone. Samsaram free, sukshma sariram is gone. Okay. So, but why they are saying all of them like that? Samsaram is equivalent to sharira sambandham. Remember that. Whether that sariram is a sthulam or sukshmam, it doesn't matter. When you are here with all this macro body every day, sthula sarira sambandham. When you are going on a sukshma sariram, going out into the archiradi margam also, until you cross, you still have that one. But why they make a karma and samsaram as a one? If you look at that one, 99% of the people, when they get out of this, fall down back to samsaram. Fall down back here. So, fall down to karma. So, that is the reason why they say. Very, very few people are going in the Archiradi Margam also, that one. So, for them, Sukshma Sariram is different. We have to do it in a different way. That's why samsara means Sthula Sarira Sambandham and Sukshma Sarira Sambandham. Okay. Chantokya Upanishad says, so you understand that one. So Chantokya Upanishad says, Ashvaiva Romani Viduya Pabam Chandraiva Rahor Mugat Pramuchyam Dhutva Sariram Akardam Kridatma Brahmalogam Abhi Sambhavani. Okay, so actually it's a simple slogan there. See, Viduya means washed, cleansed, shaken, agitated. Ashva Iva Romani Viduya. So, just like how the horse has got all this romam, all his hair and everything. Horse, what it will do? It will shake that body and the hair is shaken, any of the dirt on that one will fall down. Ashva Iva Romani Viduya Pabam. Similar to that one, when you shake, all your pavams are gone. Karma is going to be gone, that one. How the horse will shed the dirt sticking to its hair on the body, like that, deserting the pavas, deserting the karmas. And then, Chandraiva Rahor Mugat Pramuchya, another one. Here, Chandran is there, that is the moon. Raghu, the eclipse is coming and is trying to eat the Chandran, or it is trying to hide the Chandran. And how it is removed out of that one. So, Chandran is very beautiful, pleasing. Similar to that, this Atma is pleasing. The Ragu is the one basically is your Pavam. When it is removed, so another one is giving. Chandraiva Rahor Mugat Pramuchya Dhutva, having shaken, okay. Sariram akridam kridatma brahmalogam abhi sambhavani. Similar to that one, what he does, I will shake off whatever the spots I have on my character. All whatever the pavam, everything is character. Like the moon is freeing from the Rahu, from the mouth of the Rahu, I am going to get the brightness. All my pavam is gone. I am going to get the brightness. Brightness is what? Your dharmi, jnanam, is going to be not inhibited. It is going to be transparent because of the dharma buddha jnanam is transparent. Dharmi jnanam is going to be prakasham over there. So, here also it says, so the amrutam mentioned while having the sariram, a purvapakshi, you are saying that indicates Aslesha Vinashaha only. So, like this is shaking, you feel very happy. My pavam's going to be gone. With the Sanjidam Prarabdham Agami, and whatever the rest of the days I'm sitting over here, if this guy is doing the dhyanam, nothing is going to affect. He feels very happy. No pavam is there. No punyam is there. So, that is what it is talking. Aslesha Vinashaha only. When Brahma Upasagan is in this world, his happiness is because of the non-stickiness and burning of karma. The happiness oil is with the sthula sariram. That is what the amrutam is referred. Not the final eternal bliss. So this one, what he has taken from this Chantokya Upanishad Vakyam, it says, he sheds all the pavam and the atma gets out of that one. Okay. Next sutra, 497. Sukram pramanadascha tadobalabde. Sukshmam. Sukshma means sukshma shariram, what we got. Pramanadascha. Also from the Veda Vakyams, from the Pramanas, and from the Pramanas, Tada Ubalabde, thus it is being understood. Because you got a Sukshma Sariram, Pramana says like that one, we are interpreting, we are understanding that way. The subtle body is also there, Veda saying like that one, we understand. Understand what? That is what the Brahma Sutra are very cryptic. So, how do we explain this one? Sukshmam means Sukshma Sariram. Till the Archiradi Margam ends, the Sukshma Sariram is going to go. We are going to see in the Gadivisheshadigaram and also in the 4-3 of this Sribhashyam, where you go over there, you go into ஆற்றை கடக்கைக்கு தெப்பவத்தை பற்றி அதை விடுமா போலே. தேசியன் சேஸ், யூ வாண்ட் டு கிராஸ் தி ரிவர், யூ ஆர் ஹோல்டிங் ஆன் சம் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் எ பீஸ் ஆஃப் வுட் ஆர் கேட்டமரான், சம்திங் யூ ஆர் ஹோல்டிங் ஆன் தட் ஒன் அண்ட் யூ கிராஸ் தட். வென் யூ கோன் டு தி அதர் சைட், ஆர் யூ கோன் டு ஸ்டில் ஹோல்ட் திஸ் வுட் பீஸ்? யூ த்ரோ தட் அவே. தட் ஈஸ் யூஸ்ட் ஒன்லி டு கிராஸ். ஸோ வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு கிராஸ் அர்ச்சிராதி மார்க்கம். That is what it is basically used. Samsara Sagaram is still there. So cross that one, we are using the Sukshma Sariram. Sankalpa Jnanathale Viraja Nadiyai Kadandu. So within Jnanam only you will cross. You won't have any Degam there. It crosses, go to the other side. And then Amanavan Sparsam, then you are going to get a Divya Sariram. Sthula Sariram, Sukshma Sariram, Divya Sariram. So when you look at that one, the last sutra, what they told, you are looking in a different angle. We are having a Sukshma Sariram. Pramana says like that one. That means we have to travel all the way with that Sariram, cross this Archiradi Margam, then only you will attain the moksham. Not sitting down here and thinking like that one, that I am having a Jiva Mukti. Upasagan, till the end of the Archiradi Margam, Sukshma Sariram stays. You will have a Sukshma Sariram until you cross the Archiradi Margam. So, he has not shed any samsara bandham because you still have this Prakriti made out of Sariram. This is understood from the Kaushidagi Upanishad. Embarmanar brings that one. Kaushidagi Upanishad is one of the beautiful one. Kudare Vellam Sheer Govinda compares to very nicely with that one. Is a part of the Rig Veda. There is a dialogue that says, when you are in the Archiradi Margam, Chandran, the moon, will be asking a question. Kosi, kaha, asi. Who are you? Is going to ask that one. The Upasagan thinks, this is the one with the Sukshma Sariram, he thinks. How can you think? Think means you have to have Shariram. He thinks and then he says, Tam Pradi Bruyat. So I have to answer him. And Satyam Bruyat. I have to tell the truth. Those are the things he is thinking. So to talk with the Chantran, with that intention and everything, the Upasagan is answering. Upasagan is in the Archiradi Margam. He needs a Sukshma Sariram. Otherwise, he cannot talk. Otherwise, he cannot answer Chandran. Without Sariram, no one can talk here, at least in the Prakriti Mandalam. So, we need to conclude, the Upasagan who shed the Sthula Sariram has to have the Sukshma Sariram and going. Okay? So, what we are saying, in our example, we are sitting in the boarding lounge. We are having the bag and passport and everything. We are asking us to go into that kind of the jetway, go and sit in the airplane over there. An airplane takes off, we are traveling. We are not on the earth. We are not on the earth. We are not on the moksham, Archiradi Margam. Here we are not on the New York, or we are not in the Bangalore. So we are traveling in between that one. So when we are going from this place, we take your hand luggage. So the hand luggage has got certain things. What? Maybe your tablets, your medicine, your food, your change of clothes, everything. You still had to have that one to go. So similarly, the sukshmam, from the stulam it is reduced to the sukshmam, but all these things belongs to you. You have to carry and go. And that is what's happening over there. So that means you still have the bag, you still have the medicine, you still have all your belongings. You are not deserted everything and walking. That is what it says. So Upasakan and the Archiradi Margam needs a sukshma sariram. That is what this says. Sukshmam pramana dascha tadobalabde. So because the pramana says sukshma sariram exists, pramanam says, that means he has to go through the murdanya nadi, do the uttrandi, take this sukshma sariram, goes through the Archiradi Margam. You will not have the Brahma Prapti sitting with this Shariram. So therefore, until the end of the Archiradi Margam, where it is? Where this Pragrithi Sambandham ends, Viraja River is there, and then you have to cross that one. Samsara Bandham continues. Upasagan did not get moksham in this world itself. Upasagan did not get eternal bliss in this world itself. He has to cross. This is proven. That is what Emperumana writes. The next one, Sutra 498. All of them is following, trying to say the same point. Upasagan or a non-upasagan, you have to have the utkranti. You go through one path, they go through other 100 paths. That's all it is. Noba marte nada. Ada na ubamartena. Atha, therefore, based on all the reasons we have told so far, na ubamartena. Referring to the moksham which one attains in the samsara bandham is not correct. It is not. Yada sarve pramuchande kama yese hrdi shruda. Adamartyo amrudho bhavadi atra brahma samashnude. Kadopanishad vakyam. So when all the desires goes away, he gets this own happiness over here. So, no. That moksham is not that. Based on all of them, what we are telling that one. One, you are happy and aslesha vinasaha. Two, you are having brahmanubhavam here itself for a temporary period. That is what you are feeling very happy. You haven't reached the destination. That is not the eternal bliss. So he says on that one. 498, he says very straightforward. 499, this is a complex one. We'll try to understand a little. Asyaiva shobha padde durushma. Now next one is, this one is a little easier also. Asya eva cha ubapatte. Asya eva cha ubapatte. This sukshma sariram asya needs to be conforming eva cha ubapatte, and it has to conform, it has to be justified. The sukshma sariram, what we mentioned over, you need to go until the Archiradi Margam ends. That sariram needs to conform to what? Justify to what? Ushma, heat. The person dies, we will see some heat on him. The explanation here, the sukshma sariram has to be justified by the heat. So now we are going into the medicine. When the jivan leaves from the macro body, utkranti, sthula sariram, we see heat stays in a part of the body, not in whole of them. We will see the nose may get cold, hands may get cold, only some part may be very hot or warm at least. So the whole body is not warm. Whole body is warm means that it is sthula sariram macro. But only a particular point is warm, that is mean sukshmam. That means the sukshma sariram is staying over there. If the heat is from all the macro body, then you will see everywhere. But the heat may be in the heart or maybe in the shoulder, we don't know. For some people, it is different places or at the back, wherever it is. That heat is over there, that means the sukshma shariram is staying over there. And you will not see in the sthula shariram, this is very close to the death. Almost is happening or it has happened at that point, the residual heat may be there. So it is gone, the residual, the skin may be holding that. So if the heat is from the macro body, then you will see everywhere. But we are not seeing that, we are seeing only at. So here, it's not in Sibhashyam, but we can look into Purusha Suktam also. Sanda paire samdega mabadala mastaham. When you look into that one, everywhere from top to bottom it is happening. So your jnanam, even though the atma stays over some point, the dharmi jnanam is dharma buddha jnanam, on top of that it is as a quality stays. The dharma buddha jnanam spread everywhere in your body. Your atma is not in everywhere. Your atma is not in the pinky. Your atma is not in your thumb. Your atma is not in the nose. But how do you know what's happening? Because this vyabhagam, this dharma buddha jnanam has spread everywhere to understand all of them. Similarly, the heat is spread everywhere on the sthula shariram. But when the sthula shariram is going to be gone, only sukshma shariram is removed, what is called extracted out of that, all of them gets cold. Only the sukshma will be hot. And that is what he says over here. We can understand by science also as evacha upapatte. It has to confirm. Because why do we see heat in only one part, not in all other places? Because sukshma shariram stays there. He says that way. So the next one is the tough one. Sutra 500. So this is the sixth of the seven sutras. Pradiseshat idi chenna sharirat spashto yakesham. Pradishedat. Abdina is a preventing, restraining and detaining. The upasagan does not have utkrandi. That is what they are telling. If you say that one, that is actually wrong. Idi chet na, because that argument is wrong, we are saying. Sharirat. Sharirat means from jivan. What is? Spashtahi ekesham. It is clear from, in the Chantokya Upanishad, Brihadaranya Upanishad, Madhyantika Shaka, there is one of them, Emperumana takes. Based on that one, you are not correct. So, you say, sitting over here, without shedding this body, I am getting moksham, that is not correct. Why? Because I will tell you from another Upanishad, Brihadaranya Upanishad, he says. So, the Purva Paksha says, non-upasakas, they pranan goes through that own sariram, the process going through all the different worlds come back. For upasaka, pranan does not go out of this. That is what he is saying. Okay? Pradishedat. Pradishedat. Abdina, that is what it is restrained or detained. When you say like that way, the Siddhantam says the argument is wrong. How do we explain this one? Here, remember when we talked how the package has happened? There, when we said that one, vak goes to the manas and then goes to the pranan. And then we said that the pranan is inseparable from jivan. Pranan and jivan goes into the tejas and going into the all the panchabhudam. We said that way. So, here what we are trying to tell correctly, you are not understanding clearly. Like when Advaitam says, Brahmam does not have any qualities, no character. Emperumanar says, no, Brahmam does not have any bad characters. You have to insert that adjectives over there. It's a Kalyana Gunam. So when you are saying that one, no bad qualities, that is what he is saying. Similar, that one we have to interpret correctly here. The argument is wrong over here. Pranan does not leave. When he says that one here, the pranan does not leave. It stays here. He enjoys the mokshamna. No, it is not. What is meant over here? Pranan does not leave the jivan. Okay. Pranan does not leave the jivan. What it means? The utkranti, when you go, jivan and the pranan. Jivan means the atma, jivatma, and the pranan goes. Where the pranan will leave? Only when you leave the sukshma sariram, pranan will be gone. Only jivan will travel. So, until you go, pranan is there. Pranan is there means you have a sariram, you have a sukshma sariram. That is why. So, when they say pranan, it does not have utkranti, na? Utkranti means what we call as a separation. So, the separation means pranan is not separated from the sariram. That is what this guy says. It's not separate. No. Veda Vakyam says pranan is not separated from jivan. Both of them are separated from the body. That is how we have to conclude. Pranan does not leave jivatma. No utkranti for our pranan from jivan. Jivan and pranan is all the time together. Until you cross the Archiradi Margam, until you cross Samsaram, until you lose all the Deham, you need that one. So, when they say here, all the Upanishad, the Pranan does not do Utkranti, Pranan does not desert, Pranan does not go. It is not with the Shariram. See, same thing, Sadeva Somyedam Agrahasit, Egamevad Vidhiyam. When we say that one, so they say all this kind of Sajadiya Vedam, Vijadiya Vedam, Sugada Vedam, everything we saw that one. That is not a question of talking about Brahmam. This is a Srishti Prakaranam. And the Srishti, all the three kinds of causes, Upadana Karanam, Nimitta Karanam, Sagakari Karanam, everything is Bhagavan. That is what we have to tell all of them there for the about the Sati. Not whether the Brahmam has qualities. Similarly, here when we explain, the pranan does not leave. Does not leave what? It does not leave shariram. You say that. That's not correct. Pranan does not leave the jivan. So, when it goes out, the whole package goes out. That is what they are saying. Only jivan goes. Only jivan will go on the crossing of the Viraja River. So, how beautiful it comes. Sthula Sariram, Sukshma Sariram, Sariram Vittu, only Jeevan will travel. Any connection to the Prakriti is gone. Only Jeevan, Jeevatma is the only one that is going to go to the other side. There, you get all this Shariram and the Jnanam and everything transparent for you. So, the Jeevan. So, whenever you go there, Jeevan always will have a Dharmi Jnanam inside. It will have the Dharma Buddha Jnanam. But Dharmabhudhi Jnanam alone will be there, but it does not have any Namam or Rubam. Just like the Pralayam, you're laying down, that is how you'll be crossing that one. So, Purva Pakshi says that Nanupasaka is all going out. For Upasaka, Pranan will not go out. You are not correct. Siddhantam that says, Madhyantika Shaka very clearly states, Pranan does not have Utkranti with Jeevan. That is, Pranan and Jeevan goes together. It is not separated. That is what he says. So, Na Tasya Prana Utkramanti. Brihadaranya Upanishad that says, and I don't want to go too deep into this one because Emperumana wrote about 4 pages explanation here. And he is arguing on the grammar whether it is the 5th case or a 6th case. How we have to explain that Tasya part and everything. So, but at the end, what he was saying basically, Utkranti for Pranan from Jeevan is not there. That is what the meaning. Jeevan and Pranan goes together. Utkranti happens from the Shariram. It has to be. It has to shed the Sthula Shariram, but it has to get the Sukshma Shariram. There, on the Madhyantika Shaka, when Brihadaranya Upanishad, he takes that, Atha அகாமயமானஹ யோ அகாமோ நிஷ்காமக ஆப்தகாமக ஆத்மகாம ஆப்தகாமக ஆத்மகாமக. வெரி பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி இட் சேஸ். வாட் இட் சேஸ், தி பர்சன் ஹூ டஸ் நாட் ஹேவ் எனி டிசையர், அத அகாம அகாமய மயம் அகாமமயம். ஸோ திஸ் கை இஸ் ஃபுல்லி நோ காமம், நோ டிசையர். இஸ் தட் அகாம இஸ் அன்செல்ஃபிஷ், டிஸ்இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் இன் எவ்ரி திங். நிஷ்காம ஸோ இஸ் எ டிசையர்லெஸ். அகாம நிஷ்காம வெரி க்ளோஸ். ஓகே, ஆத்மகாம இஸ் ஒன்லி ஹேவிங் தி டிசையர் ஆன் தி ஆத்மா. வாட் இஸ் தட் ஆத்மா? பரமாத்மா. ஓகே, ஆப்தகாம பிகாஸ் ஈ காட் தி டிசையர் ஒன்லி பரமாத்மா, ஈ காட் எவ்ரி திங். ஆப்தகாம ஈ காட் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம். ஸோ தட் இஸ் ஒய் இஸ் டிசையர்லெஸ். ஸோ தி வே டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் திஸ் ஒன், இஃப் யூ புட் தி பக்தி ஆன் பகவான், எவ்ரி திங் எல்ஸ் இஸ் பிகமிங் வாட் யூ கால் நோ பேஷன் அட் ஆல், டிஸ்பேஷன் எவ்ரி திங் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம். அண்ட் வென் யூ காட் தி பகவான், யூ காட் எவ்ரி திங். ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் கிருஷ்ணா சேஸ், and that is what this madhyantika saga says. So tasya prana, that is what he is asking. So here I want to bring out one dialogue, just want to make sure that we understand the connection to the others, because at the end it's open ended. There are two people here, yagyavalkyar ardhat bhagar. So ardhat bhagar and yagyavalkyar, two people are talking. Okay, so yagyavalkyar and Ardhat Bhagar. So he is a Maharishi. Yagyavalkyar, you have seen that one, all the Janaka's connection and the Mahabharata and all of them, you might have seen that Yagyavalkyar. Yagyavalkyar Smriti itself is there. So the Ardhat Bhagar is asking, how many grahams are there? How many adigrahams are there? He is asking Yagyavalkyar. So the graham means not the planets. Graham means that grahikrida, attracting you. What is going to attract you? So he says, Yagyavalkyar is answering, O Maharishi, there are eight indriyams are there. The eight indriyams are nose, speech, tongue, eyes, ear, manasu, hands, and skin. So he gives, there are eight of them are there. And their vishayam, what they are getting attracted, nose to the gandham smell, vaak to the words, tongue to the rasam taste, eyes to the roopam, ear to the shabdam, manase, he says, pulls the kama, all the aasayate ilkirudu, and skin sparsam. So visesham விசேஷியம், வி சே தட். ஓகே, சிமிலர்லி ஹியர் இந்திரியம்ஸ் ஆர் விஷயி. ஸோ ஈஸ் தி ஒன் இன்செட் விஷயம்ஸ் ஆர் கமிங் லைக் எ குவாலிட்டி, ஈஸ் எ விஷயி இந்திரியம்ஸ் வாட் எவர் வி ஆர் ஹேவிங். ஸோ தட் இந்திரியம் ஆக்குபைஸ் தி காமம் கமிங் அண்ட் ஆக்குபைஸ் தி இந்திரியம். ஸோ யுவர் ஐஸ் ஆர் சீயிங், ஆக்சுவலி ஐ இஸ் தி இந்திரியம். Whatever the picture you are seeing is the vishayam. That vishayam comes and makes your eye as a slave. So the eye, indriyam, listens to that kama and it does everything. Same thing, tongue and everything. That is what Uddhava Gita talks. Here I just want to point out, this is what he is saying. The kamas make the indriyam their vasham. What can I do? I cannot escape from that one. That is what you are talking in the last Uddhava Gita class. The problem is inside, the problem is outside. Outside, kamas are coming and falling on me. Inside, my manas is thinking all of them. I cannot control either one of them. Hey Krishna, how do you do that one? So this is what the question the, all these people were asking when we are talking about starting the Hamsa Gita there. So here, same thing Yagyavalkyar and Arthabhagar. Arthabhagar was asking this question, what are all the eight indriyams and eight, this grahikrdi, they are all attracting all of them. So In Uddhava Gita also we are having the one of these Nashwaram Grahyamanancha Vidhimayo Maya Manomayam. When we say that one, Nashwaram Grahyamanancha Grahikirdu, all of them. So now the next one, Arthabhagar is asking, for which Mrityu the eyes becomes the Annam? Okay? For which Mrityu eyes become the Annam? The Devada becomes Annam to which Mrityu? He's asking all this question. Yajnavalkya gives an example. Very beautiful. Emperumana takes this one. Agni burns everything. Everything is a food for Agni, Annam. Okay? So Agni is a Mrityu. Is Mrityu is a Kalan Mari, Yaman Mari. Agni will go and eat everything. Even that Agni is destroyed by the water. You pour the water, Agni is gone. This is how this Upanishad is explaining. Okay? For Agni, Agni itself is a Mrityu. Water becomes a higher Mrityu for him. So he takes that one, but Emperumanar very polishedly says, when you say water, Narayana Padam Naram is actually the water. So Narayana Padatta, he wants to show that one over here. So the death, what we are burning and everything, for even if you burn the Mrityu, for all this burning will be gone only through the water, that is Bhagavan. So Bhagavan will take care of. He is very nicely pointing out in an indirect way in that one. So Arthabhagara is asking more. When this Jeevan faces death, that Pranan goes away from him. Okay. When the Jeevan dies, Jeevan goes out. Is it Pranan is gone? Pranan poyirtha abdina? No. Pranan will never go. Pranan goes with the Jeevan all the way. We normally say, oh, Pranan poyirtha, there is nothing there na. Well, that Pranan, whatever that kind of the indriyam kind of a thing that can hold all this pranavayu and to run all these things, that is gone. Sula sariram is lying there. That's why if you put there, ayyo moochu kaathe kaanum, is dead, pranane illa abdingano. That means Pranan is not here. It has gone out. Pranan went with the Jeevan. So the another thing we nicely understand here, Jeevan and Pranan is always together as long as there is samsaram for him, as long as they are in the Prakriti Mandalam. So next, Arthabhagara is asking, how about other things when a person dies? Okay, you are saying, what happens to all other things when he dies? He is asking. Yajnavalkya says, Maharishi, Namadeyam never goes away. How beautifully he says that one. When a person dies, Dharmaputra died, but his name is still there. Why? He's saying that Sariram is gone, Yudhishthira, Namadeyam are still there. Because Anuvritti of that Nama, we win over this Punya Logam we are attaining. So that is the reason why everybody is so interested, their name has to be popular. He's saying, Yajnavalkya, because that name is so popular, everybody keeps telling that name, and because they are telling that name, they go to the better place. That means you have to do so much punyam. When people talk about you, oh, Mahanubhava, so great and everything, Halvars are great, Acharya is great, Ramanuja is great, Desika is great. So they did so much of them. When you keep on anuvritti, keep on telling about their names and everything, we are getting cleansed. So he takes the name of Yudhishthira in this one. So that is the reason why everyone tries very hard to establish their names. To establish their names through good actions. Yajnavalkya says that way. Now, Arthabhagara continues. See, all these things why we are taking to show parallel to the Uddhava Gita what we study, or Ragasyatra Saram or Thiruvaimuri. All of them. So what is the best name you can get here? The best name is Bhagavan's Nama. Nama Uchcharanam.
Krishna has come and done so many things. Rama has done so many things. Narasimha has done that one. If you keep on iterating that one, if you keep on doing Nama Uchcharanam, you will go to the higher levels. That is what he says. Then he continues. Swami, when one dies, Vak goes and lies with that Abhimani Devata. The Vak, whatever is given, is gone. Gone means what happened? It goes to the Abhimani Devata. Okay.
Agnim vak apyedi vadam pranaga chakshuhu adityam manachandram disha shrotram prithivim shariram
yagyavalgya smriti. So on that one he says, if it does like that one, the jivan ashrayam, where that jivan goes on the dependence, who is the supporter, controller, owner of the jivan? That is the question he is asking. Beautiful question. Yajnavalkya answers that one. Hey Magarishi, the answer for this one, we should not reveal in public. Very beautifully Yajnavalkya says, it cannot be revealed in public. Please stretch your hand. And he holds his hand and he says, let's both of us determine, figure it out and do the Nirdharanam. Let's establish that one, what it is. Let's go. And that's how Yajnavalkya Smriti ends on that shaka. They are not telling who is the owner of this jivan when it goes there, supporter, controller, and owner. Smriti. Why? Because you have to go to this Shruti and you have to look into what is the Brahmam. So this jivan is always dependent, always supported, always controlled by the Brahmam. So this is what Emperumanar is taking that one and trying to show all of them. At the end he was saying, this one says basically, pranan has to be there until the Archiradi Margam ends. And then only the pranan leaves, your Sukshma Sariram leaves. Pranan leaves here when the Sthula Sariram means, pranan poiduthu, pranan has gone means, it has gone out with the jivan. So, if you are sitting at the end of the Pride, what they call Kuiper Belt and Ramari, at the end of the, what do you call, Prakriti Mandalam, when you leave the Sthula Sariram, you may not need a Sukshma Sariram probably, because you are at the towards the end of last micromillimeter of this Archiradi Margam, you may not need it. But you have to cross all over there. That's why we need all of them. So, this one he says, you need the Sukshma Sariram till you cross the Archiradi Margam. And then there is a last one there. Smaryadecha. Whatever we told all of them and it has been interpreted, proven, taken by Smriti also. And here Yajnavalkya Smriti again, Emperumanar takes and it says, Urdhvamekaha. Sthidasteshaam yo bhitva surya mandalam brahmalogam adigramya tena yadi param gadim. What it says is, among the nadis, urdvam egam, one of them going up, when the pranan, when the jivan goes through that one, breaking the surya mandalam, passing the brahmalogam, he is going to go into the Brahma Prapti. That is the Archiradi Margam. So you have to understand all of them. It says, you are getting here with the Sukshma Sariram and getting all the Upacharam from everything. You are crossing the Surya Mandalam. You are saying bye-bye to Brahma and going into the Brahma Prapti. That means Sukshma Sariram has to travel with this jivan, not sitting over here, and you are getting the Jiva Mukti. You will not have that one. So, even for the enlightened people, jnanis, departure through the Brahma Nadi, that is the Murdhanya Nadi, is needed. So, the summary of this Adhikaranam, what we are looking over here, everyone has to go through the same process of Utkranti up to a certain stage. Then other people will go all the 100 nadis. பிரம்மோபாசகன் பிரபன்னன் கோஸ்துரோதி மூர்தன்ய நாடி. And what is going over here? The package. The package is the Sukshma Sarira package. Jeevan, Pranan, Sukshma Sariram, that package is going out. So when that package is going out, that is bound for the moksham. Abdina, only in that jetway they put you. All others go through different jetways and everything. So it has to go through that one. Come out of the Uchchandalai at the middle of the head over here, and it has to travel in the Archiradi Margam. So we are sitting over here, we collected all our hand luggage, and we are asked to go through that what is called as the jetway. We go through that one sitting on the plane. You cannot do anything. Once when you go to over there, they shut the gate off. You just sit there, and then automatically the plane goes through the taxiing and go into the runway and take off. So you are still here when you are seeing that one until it takes off. So Brahmanadi it travels, still Stula Sariram is there, still on this earth and everything. When it gets out of over there, that means a takeoff. So until the takeoff it happens, all of them Niryanam, but we call that one it is happening. Yesterday they had a question after the class, Adiyan will point out that one. What would happen in the Archiradi Margam? We still have the Sukshma Sariram. Do we have any independence over there, try to do good or bad or anything, all those kinds of things? Not too much is written over there in the Archiradi Margam. Just like Yajnavalkya said, they left it. Let's go to a place, Yajnavalkya in that one he says, let's go to a place where nobody is there. Let's discuss and come to conclusion. That means all these things has to be listen to through Kalakshepam. Go to the Acharya, they had to give you. Just like in the Moolamantra Adhikaram, Imbirumanar says, 10 different possibilities are there. One of them is the best one. How do we get all of them? Go to your Acharya, he will explain that one. So it is not meant to be on the public kind of a thing. So here, that question was happening. When you are going in, say, plane, sitting down there, take off. You are not in New York, you are not in moksham. Archiradi Margam is not moksham. Archiradi Margam is not the, what do you call, your sthula sariram. You are sitting over here. But you are traveling, Prakriti Mandalam, you are traveling over there. And the travel, you don't have that much of independence. Maybe you can take off the belt and everything. Where can you go in the plane? Everybody is the same. Everybody bounded for the moksham. Not much you can do. So that's why I call, that's like a cruise mode. You are put on that one. All you are receiving the honors, you cannot do anything over there. And I'll start here, but in the next class, we will look into that one. In the Ubahara Sangraham, the Deshiyan talks all these things in Niryana Adhikaram, which is the chapter 20, Ragasatra Saram is 4.2. கதி விசேஷாதிகாரம் சாப்டர் 21 இஸ் 4.3 அச்சிராதி மார்க்கம். பரிபூர்ண பிரம்மானுபவம் பட் வி டாக் தேர் இஸ் 4-4. 4-2-3-4 பேரலல் இட்ரன்ஸ், தெர் இஸ் நோ ஓவர்லேப். பட் எம்பெருமானார் சே சம்திங், தேசியன் பிக்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் தேர் அண்ட் ரன்ஸ். பட் போத் ஆஃப் தம் வென் யூ லுக் அட் தட் ஒன், தெர் ஆர் சர்டன் திங்ஸ் தே டோன்ட் டாக். ஒன் ஆஃப் தம் இஸ் இ கிளாக். அச்சிராதி மார்க்கம் வென் யூ கோ, ஹவு லாங் ஐ ஹேட் டு ட்ராவல், இட் டஸ் நாட் சே, பிகாஸ் The time is a subjective phenomena. Time on the Earth and Jupiter to the Pluto is all different time. So that is why they never talk about time. And then what can you do on that one is also not talked over there. Both in Sri Bhashyam over there and also in the Ragasatra Saram. But Deshigan in the Ubhagara Sangraham, Chilari Ragasyam, he picks up what are all the Ubhagaram Bhagavan does for us. There, when the Jeevan dies, when you die, what kind of Ubhagaran Bhagavan does? There he takes the Gadhyam, Shanagri Gadhyam he takes and he says, Atraiva Shirange Sugamaswa. So, Imbarumanar stay here, Dvayam Attanu Sandhanena. Okay, and then, Sarira Pada Samaye Dukevalam Madhi Eivadayaya അതിപ്രബുദ്ധ മാമേവ അവലോകയെന്ന് അപ്രച്യുത പൂർവസംസ്കാര മനോരഥ ജീനമിവ വസ്ത്രം സുഖേന മാം പ്രകൃതി സ്ഥൂല സൂക്ഷ്മ രൂപാം വിസൃജ്യ.
ദാറ്റ്സ് വെരി പിക്സ് അപ്പ്. സോ ശരീരപാദ സമയേ തു കേവലം മതിയൈവ ദയയാ അതിപ്രബുദ്ധ ബുദ്ധ പ്രബുദ്ധ അതിപ്രബുദ്ധ. ഐ
എം ഗിവിംഗ് ദി ജ്ഞാനം ബിഫോർ യു ഡൈ. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദ ഹയസ്റ്റ് ജ്ഞാനം. യു വിൽ നെവർ ഹാവ് സീൻ എനി ഓഫ് യുവർ ജന്മാസ്.
വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദ ജ്ഞാനം? ദ ജ്ഞാനം വിൽ ഹെൽപ്പ് യു ടു ബി എ ഗുഡ് പേഴ്സൺ ആൻ ദി അർച്ചിരാദി മാർഗം.
ആൻഡ് വെൻ യു ഗോ ഓൺ ദി അതർ സൈഡ് അമാനവൻ സ്പർശം ഹാപ്പൻസ് ദെൻ ഓൺലി ഗെറ്റ് ദി പരിപൂർണ ജ്ഞാനം. ഓക്കെ. സോ ദി വേ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഇൻ്റർപ്രേറ്റഡ്, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് നോട്ട് സെപ്പറേറ്റഡ് അർച്ചിരാദി മാർഗം ആൻഡ് ദെൻ ലേറ്റർ. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് അതിപ്രബുദ്ധ ഈ ഗിവ്സ് ദി ജ്ഞാനം. ദറ്റ് മീൻസ് ദി ജ്ഞാനം ദറ്റ് ഈസ് ഗിവൻ ടു യു മേക്സ് യു ക്വാളിഫൈഡ് ഫോർ അമാനവൻ സ്പർശം. നത്തിങ് വിൽ സ്റ്റാപ്പ് യു, യു വിൽ ഗോ ത്രൂ ദാറ്റ്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് എ വേ ടു ഇൻ്റർപ്രേറ്റ് ഓവർ ദേർ. സോ വി കൻ സീ ദി കണക്ഷൻ ടു ദി ഗദ്യം, വി കൻ സീ ദി കണക്ഷൻ ടു ദി ഉപകാര സംഗ്രഹം ദേശീയൻ ചില്ലറ രഹസ്യം ആൻഡ് രഹസ്യത്ര സാരം ആൻഡ് സി ഭാഷ്യം. വി കണക്ട് വിത്ത് ഉദ്ധവഗീത. ആൾ ഓഫ് ദം അഡിയൻ ഓൾവേസ് സേ ദി ഫൽക്രം, ദി ഫൽക്രം ദി ലിഞ്ച് പിൻ ഫോർ ആൾ ഓഫ് ദം ഈസ് പ്രപത്തി ശാസ്ത്രം. എവറിഥിങ് ടൈസ് ടു ദറ്റ് വൺ ആൻഡ് വി ആർ ലുക്കിംഗ് എവറിഥിങ് ത്രൂ ദി ഗ്ലാസ് ഓഫ് പ്രപത്തി. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് വാട്ട് വി ആർ ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റഡ് ഇൻ. ആൾ അതേഴ്സ് മേ ബി but not too much useful for us, for Prabannan, for the rest of the days. So, abharadam illada kaingaryam. So, what can we do? Enjoy all these things so that we don't make any mistakes. Keep our boarding pass very safe. We'll stop here.
Kavidharkika simmaya kalyana gunashaline Srimade Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Srimade Nighamanta Mahadeshikaya Namaha. Adiyan, adiyan.